In this example, we want to calculate the actual residence time in a plug flow reactor, where we have a gas phase reaction with a mole change. And so the residence time is going to be different from the space time because the volumetric flow rate changes as we move through the reactor. And so we have a reaction with one mole forming two moles, and the information on the reactor and the temperature and pressure are given. The space time is the reactor volume over the inlet volumetric flow rate. And the inlet volumetric flow rate we can calculate from the ideal gas law. We have only A coming in, so this is the molar flow rate of A, the gas constant, absolute temperature over pressure. So I've substituted in checking units consistent, we can get the inlet volumetric flow rate, which means we can get the space time. Now, this space time would be the residence time in the reactor if there were no mole change, no pressure drop, and it was constant temperature. So now we want to calculate the actual residence time in the reactor. The residence time is going to be an integral where the volumetric flow rate in the denominator here is changing as we move down the reactor. So we integrate over the reactor volume from the inlet to the outlet of the reactor. And we're going to solve this by writing it as a differential equation, namely differentiating this respect to volume, where the initial condition then is that at the inlet, V equals zero, T equals zero. And to solve this equation, we need to know how the volumetric flow rate changes as a function of the cumulative volume in the reactor. That's a function of how much reaction takes place, which means we need to solve the mass balance, first order reactions. That's the molar flow rate of A, and here's the molar flow rate of B. Here's how we account for the stoichiometry. And the inlet flow rate of A is 100, and for B at 0. So we can solve these equations simultaneously. We need to also calculate the concentration from the molar flow rate and the volumetric flow rate, and we need to calculate the volumetric flow rate from the total molar flow rate, so that's the flow rate of A plus the flow rate of B, and then the gas constant, temperature, and pressure, just the ideal gas law. So what we can do is take these equations and then also put into, in this case, a polymath program, the values for the pressure and the temperature, the gas constant, and integrate from the initial volume of zero to the total cumulative volume of 60 cubic meters. And when we do that, we calculate a residence time. So the residence time is 95 minutes. This is what we're interested in calculating. Notice this is significantly less than space time because this increase in the volumetric flow rate. So what I'm showing here is the polymath program where we have the differential equations for the mass balance, differential equations for the residence time, the starting volume or integrate to the final volume, and we calculate the volumetric flow rate and the concentration in the reactor. And so the molar flow rate of A decreases, the molar flow rate of B increases more than the decrease in the molar flow rate of A. And this is the volumetric flow rate, so you can see it increases significantly. And these are the details of the calculations, the output from the polymath program, where it shows the residence time and the actual equations and the Runge-Kutta technique used here. We were able, by integrating, to calculate the residence time in the reactor, and it changes from the space time because of the increase in the number of moles due to reaction.